Hi, let's talk about veins and lymphatics. So this should be a short discussion. Recall that the internal jugular vein, or the IJV, just the IJ for short, descends the neck within the carotid sheath, and then it's going to meet up with the subclavian vein at the root of the neck. Where these two vessels come together is an area known as the venous angle. The venous angle is the start of the brachiocephalic vein. The left brachiocephalic vein is much longer and more oblique than the right brachiocephalic vein. So these two brachiocephalic veins come together to form the superior vena cava. Or the SVC. Let's erase some of this here. Lymphatics are vessels that help to conduct lymph, which is basically reabsorbed interstitial fluid that does not get absorbed by capillary beds. So there are specialized lymphatic capillaries that will conduct this excess fluid away from tissues and back into venous supply. Now, on the right side of the body, and we can't see this here, but entering into the vicinity of the right venous angle, we have the right lymphatic duct, and that right lymphatic duct is going to drain the lymph from the right head and neck, the right upper limb, and the right side of the thorax. Now, these three trunks are known as the jugular trunk from the head and neck, the subclavian trunk, that's a familiar name, from the upper limb, and the bronchomediastinal. From the thorax. Now, these trunks are also present on the left side as well. Only on the left side, they feed into the thoracic duct. The thoracic duct actually starts inferior to the diaphragm with a dilation that is often present called the cisterna chyli. That cisterna chyli is going to receive lymph from the lower limbs, the pelvis, the abdominal wall, the viscera, and then all of that lymph is going to be conducted via the continuation or the thoracic duct, which we can see here. That thoracic duct actually enters into the thoracic cavity on the right side of the esophagus. And then it crosses over at about the sternal angle, which would be about there, onto the left side. And then it ascends next to the trachea. And it wraps around the carotid sheath and then inserts in the vicinity of that venous angle. So the thoracic duct could insert on the left IJ, the left subclavian, it can insert on the brachiocephalic, but somewhere in this venous angle, we have that insertion of the thoracic duct. Those trunks, the jugular, subclavian, or bronchomediastinal trunk, can all independently insert on any of those venous elements in the vicinity of the venous angle, but it's easier to conceptualize them coalescing into ducts and then going into the venous angle. So we've discussed the veins in this area and the associated lymphatic trunks and then ducts. Thank you for your time.